This operation has started in 1997. So we have been doing this for 20 years. This is our 20th year running this banding station. So my name is Mike Magnuson. I'm the wildlife biologist for Lassen Volcanic National Park. And we are out here today in beautiful Warner Valley, doing what we call a mist netting operation here. We're banding neotropical songbirds is what we're doing. So this consists of a series of 10 nets that we have set up. And these nets are called mist nets. The birds really can't see them. The birds fly into the nets and we capture the birds in the nets.
We check the nets every half hour, extract them, bring them back to the station. And the most important things that we get on them are age and sex. So we get a general idea of what the population is doing in an area. So who's breeding, if there are more males or females.
Population densities, migratory patterns, dietary habits. Just this year we started up collecting fecal samples to see what kind of insects and seeds the birds have been eating.
So we're looking for a good baseline. How are our birds doing initially, and then how are they gonna be doing in the future?
The age is 2 by I, sex is M by H, 9 for the skull. Zero brood fetch, zero CP, zero fat.
Okay, so what are you?
Zero body molt, zero flight feather molt, PP wear and fade are both 0.
And this is one of many banding stations that we have across the country. It's the only one we have in Lassen Volcanic National Park, but there are many of these MAP stations. And MAP stands for Monitoring, Avian Productivity, and Survivorship.
And MAP stations are kind of a standard that is through North America and some South America. And every 10 days, you try and band at least once during that period.
So the data that we collect here actually goes into a huge database, and it goes to the Institute for Bird Populations. And they take the numbers and crunch the numbers, and they can kind of tell how bird populations are doing throughout the country and throughout the world. And we're just part of that operation. So right now we've done this for 20 years. We've had one analysis and our birds are doing fairly well. So we're really looking to see how our birds are doing. Are they declining? Are they increasing? Or are they being fairly stable? Right now they're fairly stable.
For the first time in my experience, we just caught a Steller's jay. That was pretty interesting. I wasn't really sure exactly, what band size it needed or exactly how to measure it.
Sex is...
Can you tell?
Just don't kick me in the face, please.
So each bird gets a band that's only that bird in the whole world gets that band number, kind of like a social security number. And then we can tell if that bird gets caught again. We know exactly who it is and where it came from. We've done this for 20 years, so we want to keep this analysis going throughout the years. So hopefully we can run this banding station for quite a while and get bird numbers throughout, the decades actually is what we're looking to do.
BP, CP, fat or zeros.
Birds are really a neat thing to look at. They're fun and they're a great indicator of, your health and ecosystem environment. It's one of my favorite parts of my job, actually. This is it right here. This is what I live for. This is what I want to do. I love birds. And I think this is a great project that we've got going on. And I want to keep it going. As long as I'm here, I'm going to be running this banding station every year.